even more so important nowadays, to give our kids the technology tools that they need. When I went to Albany, the first thing I did when I was elected to the State Assembly in 2000 was join with a progressive group of clergy and labor leaders that were engaging in a 40-hour fast, not eating for 40 hours, to highlight the need to raise the minimum wage. In those days, in 2000, the minimum wage in New York State was stuck with the minimum wage, the federal government, which was very, very low in those days. Nobody thought we could get it done because the Republican State Senate never wanted to raise the minimum wage, but we did it. We engaged in that 40-hour fast year after year. It was only about a dozen legislators that would join. Out of over 200 state assembly, state senate, only about 10 or 12 of us would join this progressive group of clergy, religious, and labor leaders. But lo and behold, we brought attention to the issue and we changed the minimum wage. We increased the minimum wage in New York State. Now, obviously, much more needs to be done. The second thing I did when I went to Albany, in my first term, 2002, in fact, I passed this great bill known as the Senior Citizen Rent Increase Exemption. It allows seniors who are of fixed income to not receive any rent increases if they're already paying more than 30% of that fixed income into rent. It's only fair. And of course, you know, over the years it gets an increase, and my good brother, Assembly Member Wright, increased it, and now it's $50,000. That's how much seniors can now earn up to $50,000 and not receive the rent increase. So, and I hope to get into more of the discussion as we progress with the questions and answers. Thank you so much.
Thank you to your excellencies, the Reverend Clergy, and to all our distinguished moderators, to all who gather here. I want to thank HREF for the invitation. To my beloved